Are you all right, G?
Alexa.
Hey, in the back there, is that a saddle that he's got? Just to the left of Kofi. Is that a saddle? Huh?
It's a pillow.
Oh, okay, look like
it's like it's in the corner of his couch.
Black saddle. It's like, damn, that boy's kinky. Uh-oh, that's emphysema. Man, that's emphysema.
Ooh, shit. Fucking hell.
Check one, two. Check one, two. Here we go. And five, four, three, two. Two and a half. Good, coming at you pre-recorded. Same people from last week. Here we go again, episode number two, Cold Rides Media, brought to you by. So we got E, we got Gerald, and we got myself. My name is Raymond. Thank you so much for viewing again this week. You saw us last week. Now we're back. We had a lot of positive feedback. Maybe one or two kind of questionable if it was a backhanded compliment, but yeah. That's why we're looking for that. We're looking for people to chime in. Please say something in the comments, because I know I don't know what was going on with the comments last week. We saw maybe like one or two, but let us know in the comments what we can do better, what we can probably talk about for you, and how we can connect somehow. But for this week, just wanted to touch base with the boys. I again am based in Dallas, Fort Worth, North Fort Worth, and Gerald and Eric are still back over in Seattle, in the C-Town area. What is it like? GSA? Is that what you guys are calling it now? I saw that somewhere. It was a Greater Seattle area.
That's what I heard too. GSA, Greater Seattle area.
Is that what it is now? Because it's DFW over here. So
I don't know. I just call it the town.
You
just call it the town.
Some Cali people brought that up. I was like, we're gonna call this GSA.
GSA.
Okay.
Congratulations.
GSA. Little trendy foods. What's up, man? What you guys do? What you guys do over the weekend? So we're taping this right now on a Monday, so we're just catching up. What'd you get into this weekend, bro?
What did I get into? Oh, I went to the casino. It was my lady's birthday, so we spent time out there in Tulalip. Wasn't too bad out there, so it was a time well spent.
Any shows?
No.
Any shows? Is it like Earth, Wind, and Fire?
No. But you know, we come back to town though. 112.
Okay.
Yeah,
did I win no money?
Broke me this time.
Now, did you see the uncles and aunties and everything too? You got to do your rounds when you get up there. It was like, maybe hit them up for a couple honeys.
That shoulder tap, Tito, can I get a dollar? Buy me a drink, please.
What's up, G? What you end up getting into?
Mine was cool. My nephew, he's about to become a doctor. It was his white coat ceremony today at UW on Friday.
That's filthy.
Yeah.
Nice. Crazy. Congratulations to the Neff.
I used to baby. I used to babysit and wipe his butt.
Man, yeah. I like that. There's not enough getting into that. You know, we're all getting into our creativity side rather than tapping into our what our parents wanted us to be. So we're in the hospitality business. Yeah. Okay. So let's kick it through. First thing what we want to get to is and I personally didn't think that we were even going to consider this as a little segment on the show, but we had some feedback last week. Actually, it wasn't this show. It was actually a new series that we had started under Cold Rice Media. It's the feature series. And if you watched our initial show on episode one for Was Good, in the introductions, I did bring up my situation with E, and I initially wanted to bring him in one of those video series to have him on the show and just give him a little feature, because I was thinking about, you know, I was like, who do I want to reconnect with? Who do I want to sit down with? And he was definitely one of the cats. And I brought him in for that first episode. And there was a segment in there that one of our viewers actually was very interested in. It kind of captured him, which is basically I asked him, being a fashionista, being this clothing designer. Here in Dallas, Fort Worth, it's the average temperature is like 104, 105 degrees. And I asked him, I was like, what would you dress me in if I went to a barbecue and it's like 105 degrees and nobody has ever met me there before? How would you put together an outfit? So he said, well, what'd you say?
fitted cap, a chain, a Sean Camp jersey. Some camo shorts and some Air Maxes.
And some, the Brazil Dunks. I don't even know. But the Brazil Dunks. And I was like, all right. And I was like, I have none of that in my closet. But one of our viewers out there actually came through and was like, yo, he did DM us, or he, I don't know how I got forwarded this picture of, what's his name? Jeremy? How do you say that? Jeremiah?
Jeremiah.
We'll call him Jeremy. With this fit, it blew me away because he just rushed upstairs and was like, yo, peep me out with my curtains. So yeah, shout out to Jeremy, viewer submission of the week. Now,
hey, that's love.
Look
at Jeremy. No, Jeremy's one of our boys. He hit us up right away. He's very much on the show. Very much appreciate him, you know, just hitting us up. Again, didn't expect it to be a little segment in our show here, but I think we're gonna start doing that here. Let's take.
Who wore better?
Look at my boy. Look at my boy,
Jeremy.
He looked like the manager at Jersey's. But okay. Hey, Jeremy, so thank you.
Your jet adore is looking for you.
My guy. Well, shout out to Jeremy. Thank you so much. And again, and since that's now a new feature on our show, or a little segment, we'd like to hear from you. If you got something to show us, if you got, you know, just show a little bit of love to show, we'll hook you up. All right. But let's see. What was that? What was today's show? Today's show is that relatable yet debatable show, which is, as advertised, our top five rappers of all time. Now, I mean, it's everybody's. I think there's quite a few shows that's already done this before professionally, and I think and also just, you know, some other podcasters like us out there, they want to do this. From what I've seen out there, the way they've debated this thing, it was either favorite or if it was just greatest rapper of all time, and there really wasn't there wasn't a lot of qualifiers or parameters in the whole thing, which if you don't put that there, you start getting a little crazy. Because you'll have some outliers, you know. I don't know, name somebody that would be in someone's top, like Talib Kweli.
Yeah, you can't do favorites. Too biased.
And you'd have like Big Daddy Kane as one of the best rappers of all time, and mad respect for Kane. But I mean, if you're talking about all time, you know, you're gonna have to lay down some qualifiers. So it was hard. It was hard, and we all had our assignment. And unfortunately, not all of us kind of got the assignment right. So we're going to have to kind of flip this thing a little bit. So we're going to do a judge and jury. We're going to have a judge as far as Gerald today. He'll be our judge, and E and I will mention our lists. And then the jury, I mean, we're hoping to get some participation out there, you know, in the comments or in, you know, you can DM us. We're always open for the DM. But for right now, any thoughts, E, going into this thing, Gerald?
Nah. I'm just going to talk about it.
Did you guys have any tactics, like any strategies on how you put this thing together? I surely did.
I did kind of think about it a little bit. What music was before and how it inspires people today. That kind of influence, it doesn't matter to me if it's... Because, you know, most of the people I'm about to select today... kind of moved on into a bigger thing, like owning businesses and stuff like that. And it's not to me necessarily about the music, but it is because the music was the big influential part of it all that started it, you know? So that's how I kind of looked at it.
Okay. Yeah. So let me actually share our qualifiers or criteria that we were working with to keep us on track and actually choose a list here. Go down the qualifiers here. So number one is impact. Impact is basic. I mean, it's kind of self-explanatory. It's how they affected their time, their audience during that time, their community, their, you know, and also their fan base, and within that fan base, positively, negatively. The second part is, and also in addition to that, impact beyond their actual time, right? So how even people are thinking about them right now. Second part is body work, you know, the records that they put out there, just their, like, the albums and how much they put out as far as their catalogs and achievements and everything like that that comes into it, the awards and achievements. So that was one of the big things. So obviously, if you start taking a look at, you know, some of your favorite, some of the favorite rappers that you would put up there, some of them would drop down if you start taking a look at this, just the first top two there. Okay. The next two are actually one that you can push for your favorite rappers, like your lyrical mastery is written. Lyrical mastery would be their flow, their, you know, their cadence, their deliveries, and there's the vocal prowess, you know, like. That one would be very high on Biggie, because Biggie was out there and he's a monster and he would always be heard for that. Written, you'd have your, and that's basically if you got Crazy Pen. Rakim had Crazy Pen. M has Crazy Pen. Kendrick, Kendrick and Pac, craziest pens out there. I mean, they'll tell stories and keep you on point. And then lasting power. This is longevity. This is the ones that, not even the fact that, you know, if they lasted that long, but it's just their relevance even right now. So that's basically what we're working with. So E, how did that, did this itself change your list at all as far as when you were making it from what you would normally put as your favorites?
Yeah, because I kind of had a deep dive and do kind of some homework and mm-hmm. find the reason why I kind of like these artists.
Okay. And G,
you know me, I had to throw mine out because I picked a lot of my favorites.
G, can you? So yeah, you went favorites, and mind you, there's definitely nothing wrong with that. I'm actually interested again. I have the list somewhere on my phone, but who was on your list just to share?
I kind of went in order of the way I've listened to them. So it came Tupac, Biggie, Nas, Busta Rhymes, and Quali.
So Pac, Big, Nas, Busta, and Quali. Okay. Mm-hmm. And that's the favorite list. And nobody else is like slipped in there. I was like, hey, I kind of like this hit. Because, you know, last week I asked, I wanted to see how our original, us being old heads, our original list, we had all these guys that we were hyped about that we went to the clubs with. And mm-hmm. those were the guys that we messed with, like Mos Def back then. I'd love to put him up there if he only stayed around.
Yeah, I did have a lot more, but I just I got to follow rules. Like, I keep it fine.
Yeah. Well, then I also wanted to see how those guys.
I was going to ask you if we could have like a bench, a five player bench. Oh, just like.
The six man.
Yeah, I was like, fuck, I can't.
I mean, the honorable mentions were there. I think you guys shot out some of those, but those have been relevant. But as I was saying, it was also, I wanted to see how our top five back then, growing older and listening to just the changes in music, and also some of the legends kind of dropping off and new heads coming in. Like, I mean, I saw a few lists out there. I was like, whoa, they're up there already, and they've already replaced this legend. I wanted to see if that changed anything in your mindsets and in your outlook and the music nowadays. Maybe a little bit of flexibility in our, you know, in our eardrums. But I think this list will reflect a little bit of that. I think so. Okay. So you ready to go? So what we're going to do here is I'm going to mention my top five. We'll go back and forth. Actually, you and I will go back and forth. 5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 1. And then after we've mentioned that, we're going to have to make our arguments to Gerald as to why that person fits best in that position. And he's already going to know who the rest of ours are. So you're going to have to study those five and be like, all right, at first you'd have to agree. Initially, your mind, you know, as a person, human being, you'd be like, I agree with this side more than the other. So I'm going to have to sway you. Or E would have to sway you. Fair?
Fair. Ooh.
Got it? Okay. And then again, folks out there, go ahead and chime in.
I'm trying to persuade you here, G.
You want a cup of water?
Hey, now you better pick me. Now I would kick you out.
If you guys don't know, E is a He and Gerald are in the same house right now, and they're doing a very good job with the audio not crossing over.
All right, be so loud. Well, I'm gonna walk over to the other room, and I'm be like, "Hey, you better pick this one, G." All right. So, are we doing explanations too?
We'll go. Just naming them off, and then we'll run it back. Okay.
So my number five is Lil Wayne.
Wheezy.
Lil Wheezy.
Mine would be his little protege, Drake.
Ooh.
As number five. Okay. And I'll go ahead and go with my number four. And it's I mean, people are gonna clap at me on this, but it's the legend Tupac Shakur at number four.
Number four.
I know it's tough.
I think people think that's kind of high.
Not my favorite list, but it's my list. Ooh, yes,
that's a dozen. Must have did a lot of.
Please reference
number four.
Please reference the criteria box in the upper left corner.
Yeah. I think he got favorite list.
I got a favorite list too. Number four. So I'm just gonna freestyle my whole thing. But no, my number four would be Kanye. I put Kanye out there. Yay! Come on, yay!
Yay!
Yeah, I know you like yay, Jay. Come on, G, you gotta tell me.
Hey, we ain't at that round yet. Okay, who's your number three?
I like the
Go ahead, kick me number three.
Okay, number three.
Not barefoot, yay?
No, not barefoot, yay. Hey. Number three, Jay-Z. I got Jay-Z at number three.
Jay-Z, okay.
Young Hova.
Did I say number four?
I like that position. Okay,
yeah, Jay-Z number three, ooh. You're gonna get some East Coasters at you. All right, number three for me is Wheezy.
Wheezy
F baby.
Okay.
And I would go number two would be Jay-Z.
He's up there.
Okay.
That's good. I like that positioning.
And your number two would be
Notorious Big. Biggie Smalls at number two.
He's still up there. The relevance.
He's still up there.
Have him, huh, Raymond?
I don't know. Is it
three, four, five? I don't know.
Will I upset some people? All right, E, who's your number one, bro?
Who's your number one, E?
My number one, bro, gotta be Tupac. So hearing you at number four with Tupac,
number
I'm like,
four. Oh. I know I'm hurting even saying it, but I'm gonna let you know why.
It makes your list kind of look like favorites, E.
I know they are kind of like favorites, though.
I know. I'm not mad at your list at all, but my number one. He would be actually my goat on my other one would be M. Ooh, M would be my goat. M, hands down. I know there's some missing cats out there. You know, you got some. There's like a lot of consolation prizes.
I like
so
your
at
list,
first
though.
Look.
I like your list though.
At first look, G, who you favoring? Don't even look at E across the room and having him kick you out.
Because I like your list. I like your list because it's not stacked as a favorite. And then E's, you got two. I know Tupac's his favorite.
All right. Well, folks, that's the end of that competition. So we're going to go ahead and move on.
Game's over.
So that's pretty much it for the show. Thanks for the viewer submission from Jeremiah. No, I'm just playing. All right. This is.
Wait, so did you get ready voted?
Jeez with it. Okay. Since he's favoring you. He's favoring me at this point. My list. Okay. Again, my list. Drake.
I was lopsided already. So.
Oh, no. It kind of is, you know. But it's all right. Let's talk it through. Let's talk it through. We're all friends here and family. All right, E. Why would you put. So, I mean, I can understand Pac, but explain your list. I mean, if you can go, you want to go like one for one, or if you just want to explain your list entirely and how you got there.
My list, how I picked it.
Yeah,
it was always kind of like favorites, but at the same time, these are my favorites because I've listened to them and kind of followed their journey.
Mm-hmm.
So they influenced me in a way through their music, just because the music's dope also. They're just out here, and I feel like if you were to play it right now, people would still listen to them.
Okay. So let me ask you, Wheezy, if we were to go with the criteria that we've worked with, okay? Impact, body, so I can understand. So Wheezy at number five, mm-hmm. under Ye.
Under Yeezy.
You know what I'm saying? He's the versatile.
You want me to grade your pick like a draft?
Are you doing draft picks now? Draft pick grades?
That would, because, I mean,
that would like describe it perfectly.
Lil Wayne's filthy though. Like
Lil Wayne is filthy, bro.
He's filthy. You know,
he's number one in a lot of people's lists. I mean, especially the people not in the West Coast.
Yeah.
I'd at least have Weezy over Kanye on your list,
D. I was thinking about too to make the switch, but I don't know.
You can make the switch.
Okay. You can make the switch. I'll switch it. I'll search it for you.
Ye wouldn't even be in my top 10, real talk. No? I mean, he's like an all-around cat. Ye wouldn't even be there. I appreciate, like, but he can't. Now, mind you, he had back-to-back-to-back just monster albums, right? But I also put that on him being a crazy producer. Like, mm-hmm. he's one of the best producers all time. He's goated there. But lyrically, I mean, three stats would eat him. Easy.
Okay. So you hurt me on that one.
No, I mean, lyrically, Nas would get him easy. Oh, yeah. I mean, Nas's catalog is up there too, but he just has those albums.
My favorite rapper is his ghostwriter.
I'd even think about that? Nas too. It just totally slipped my mind. Nas is filthy too, though.
My thing with Nas is this, and I rocked Nas. Like, if you still remember, G, like, we were in the drop, pulling up at the gas station, If I Ruled the World, and it would just echo.
And that was the reason why.
So, Nas, Illmatic, hands down one of the best ever. Ever. Not even, like, a first album, like, an intro album, like, a freshman album. Best albums ever. But then he fell off on two, in my opinion. He fell off on the next two until he came back with not even Stillmatic. That was the one. What was the one with If I Ruled the World? That album was what put him back. So that was my thing. When I was going back and forth with that thing, after Illmatic, a lot of his stuff was just good. And I started listening, and he's put out a lot of stuff since then. And every time I listen to the albums, it's just like, oh, this is good. Okay, this is good. It wasn't like, oh, this is, it wouldn't blow me away. It was like, yo, it wasn't memorable. It was like, oh, he's back. Oh, he's eating cats. He's just constantly good, good, good. And I had brought up a little bit earlier when we were chopping it up, Never Die is a track that he recently has in his most recent album. I listened to it when I was driving around today. It's him. Now, if you guys haven't heard, it's him. And Weezy featured on that thing. And I was trying to see how these guys managed to stay their raps grow and become still relevant to the old heads and also still relevant to the younger kids. Nas had a good verse, a really good verse. But when I listened to Weezy's verse, it was over. It was over. It was just, he ate him in three bars. And I was like, what in the, like, and I love Nas. Nas is, you know, he's definitely up there as a Hall of Fame legend, but Weezy just hits different. He just
hits
different.
What do you got Weezy at? What number?
Number three.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me talk my through. Okay. So Drake, I mean, come on, man. I love him or hate him, ghostwriter or not, Drake, when he touches the mic now and his catalog, his impact out there to these young heads. I mean, the body work, the catalog. I mean, I'm just looking at this thing down. He's got crazy writtens, all aka on his BlackBerry.
Yeah,
and he'll just
you having him at number five. I was okay with that.
You good with that? Yeah, how do you like that? And then with Pac was the hardest one to move down there because he to me could be easily number one if he wasn't a casualty. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. His catalog, his body work. Was enough to make give him my top five before he even passed. Because even that during that time, he was already in movies and everything. He was starting to make that transition over to you know just to be a full on entertainer as opposed to this, as opposed to what he left us with. Impact basically was the thing that kept him in my top five because that guy was he influenced cultures. He influenced. Kids that weren't even born yet. And when they were born and they listened for the first time, they're like, I like him because he had the ability to, what I appreciate about him is he had that pen to where he can write and stay on point. And there's a lot of OG, a lot of like great heads right now that have, that don't have the ability to communicate with you through song and keep at the same point. Like Dear Mama, put that on right now, and you're feeling everybody the whole way through. Brendan's Got a Baby the whole way through. You know what I'm saying? And that'll be like, if you had this kid that's going, you know, that's going through some stuff, like, you know, in the same stuff that he's going through back then, you pop that on, he's like, oh my goodness, that's me. And he communicates it through there. So that the pen's crazy. And last thing, longevity. I mean, I don't even know if they're still teaching his there was college courses back then with his poetry. So that's why, I mean, he's always going to be up there. He just couldn't get up to the top three for me. Just because, you know, it's just these other three is just the lasting part. Like Weezy's at number three for me, it was hard for me to put him under Jay. It was hard for me to even put Jay in the top five. I'm not a big Jay fan. But I put Weezy at number three. If you guys don't remember, Weezy, like when Jay retired in, I was at 03 or something like that, when he said, I'm retired. And then M was dealing with his pill issues. Weezy went through and just owned the entire. Did you forget his mixtape?
For sure.
His mixtapes were, Ellie, if you look up his mixtapes, there's like 20, 25 mixtapes just alone, not even. Yeah.
P.O.D.
I mean, and then you put out your actual albums. Carter 1 through what? Like Carter 6 is coming out. Carter 6, Relevance. And this is what, so with 2 and 3, I was trying to figure out, okay, Impact. I was gonna make a point for Weezy to be number two because he founded Drake and he ran with Drake and he founded Nicki. And now who's gonna be leading the next gen? And all these kids, like these, I mean, Nicki's right there is debatably the dopest rapper and like the best female rapper out there.
Looking at your list, I think you could switch them to two.
It makes a play, right?
It makes a play. But, I see your play there.
Yeah, you cannot discredit Lil Wayne at all.
No.
Yeah, number here. Five.
And he eats, bro.
No. Now it's making me feel bad about it, but you know.
Weezy, every single, like you don't want to, like he's the other guy that you don't want to feature on the feature because he'll
eat. Yeah, he's eat you.
Because he will eat. He's out there and it's like what from, I don't know if it's true. It can't be true. But it's amazing if it is true, and I'd probably put him at one if that's the case. But every single, like, from my understanding, he doesn't write down any of his stuff. It's all like, oh my goodness.
I saw a video of him saying he saw a Jay-Z do it, and from that day, he's like, he stopped doing it. He would always just write down just because he got something going on, you know. But he was like, I could do what he does. I could just say it in my head.
Absolutely,
and remember it and perform it.
It's crazy.
Just rock the mic and just do that shit like ain't nothing. I don't know, man. That's
amazing.
That's tough. That's for sure talent.
And to still eat this, that like a lot of cats dropped off. A lot of cats didn't make. Remember, like there was a point where all our legends back then just kind of fell off. Mm-hmm. And to bounce back and even be more relevant after all that, right? So yeah, that's why I had to put them up there, man. I'd love to make a. I mean. If I woke up like a week from now and be like, you know what? No, Weezy's better than Jay. But Jay is, I mean, it's Jay. The reason why I never really gave Jay all his props, and maybe I'm fully wrong about this thing, is I truly believe he inherited the rap game after Pac and Big went.
Yeah.
Like nobody, like, where do we go? Like East Coast was,
I went.
Right?
Yeah,
because that's why he went straight at Nas, bro. He went at Nas. Like, yeah, he went at Nas. It's like, who's gonna own the East Coast? And if I get Nas, then I'm gonna be the lone soldier up top. But what he didn't understand was Nas already had him. Mm-hmm. But Nas decided to take a step back and was like, nah, I had you. That's all we need to prove. Now you can take the business side. And like what you said, E, a lot of these guys are just business. And that's what we're dealing with, right? We've got a list of businessmen that just are striving right now.
Moving on. That's what they got to do. Right?
So what?
Music's there, man. Music's eternal.
What made you keep Pac and Big up there? I know it's like, it's... I get it.
I think because it was just the feeling they gave me. Like what you were saying a while ago, like a song. What was that, like Dear Mama? I could listen to that thing all the way through.
Bro,
and think about my mom and like the stroke. Yeah, exactly. You'll feel it. The emotions behind that whole song, this word, lyric by lyric, you know, and that's why he's still up there. It's just the music for me. And then his whole transition into being a movie actor and kind of being an activist also. To me, that pushes me in a way. It's like, okay, this is something bigger than just Tupac, because he's also he's spitting facts, and they had to silence him for that. And and it's crazy, like you said, you know, they're teaching people out there what Tupac was spitting, you know, like all this literature and stuff. And it's just crazy. So that right there is just the whole impact for me. I had to put him at number one. I feel him all the way out. Biggie, you know, he was over. He was like the East Coast version of Tupac, because he could relate to the people out there. Nobody else could. I had a struggle with kind of understanding what he was talking about till I really dug deep into, you know, his music. And I was like, oh, man, he's spinning the same thing. It's just, you know, different verbiage. So that's why I kind of have him out there.
Remember back when the whole East Coast, West Coast thing was going on?
Yeah.
And when we were just riding so hard with Pac's thing, it was like when I think we were at a beach and one of the homies came through with a big old boombox. I don't know, G, if you were there that day, and it was Pac's Hit Him Up.
Yeah, all the time.
And it was like, I don't know, I don't want to cuss in the cast, but at the pod, but it was like, I effed your bitch. What you said, bitch?
Crazy.
And then
that was the hardest shit I ever heard. The
entire beach went crazy. We're like, what is this? And it's like, oh, is that the new Pac? And he called out everybody. So at that point, we rode hard for him so bad. Even though what was the group that he made? It was like Pac, like the, was it not the dog?
Outlaws.
The Outlaws. They were bunk. But we still rode for Pac. He carried them.
Yeah, we were hard.
Outlaws were whack, bro. We were like, come on. Outlaws.
I Get Around was probably the best collab that he had with Outlaws.
Yeah, but was digital.
I was still listening.
Digital Underground?
Everyone was listening.
No, Outlaws.
I liked them both.
No, but then I was having such a hard time. Like, I was undercover Biggie. Like, kind of, I was liking all his stuff. But I was like, man, no.
You fat. What was in the car rolling around was Tupac. But at home,
we
played that Biggie.
Yeah. I appreciated Big, like his cadence, his delivery. It's just every single beat, like every single area he was able to fill it. It was so masterful, man. That's why, you know, I can't be mad at Big or Pac at number one or two. But you know, oh, but my number one, I mean, I don't know any rapper right now that can really touch M.
Mm-mm.
I don't like or want to touch M. Weezy's pretty damn close.
It's close.
Because
you don't want both of them on your album.
No, I mean, there's a reason why there's a hashtag M goes last. And and every single feature, M goes last. And he'll just, they'll create a brand new beat for him within the song. They'll have a transition over to his own specific type of a beat because you know he's gonna eat. And
he's gonna kill it for sure.
He changed everything. I mean, he made it worldwide. You know, there's kids in Germany freaking just rapping M songs, and he created this brand new type of a following with the stans. You know, everybody started naming themselves like, oh, we're stan followers, and then all of a sudden you got all these other fan bases out there that just start naming themselves. So, and it still stays to this day. He's sick. So
filthy, man. Eminem, he was an honorable mention for sure.
Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't you? Okay, so why wouldn't you put him in top five?
I don't know, man.
Because these are his favorite five.
No, I mean, lyrically, you know, hey, N's filthy. He spits. He any way he wants to. He'll create a masterpiece easily. You know, he was our jam back in the day. And I think he's kind of the reason why I do, you know, I'm not going to say it on here, but, you know, the things that I do. I don't know, man. Like, I just didn't really see him out there like that. Like, his impact is like, what is he really, what's he doing now? You know, and then, like, some of his last album to me was like, it was okay. It just felt like it was almost all the same. Every every song that was on that last EP he had.
I had a hard time, like, let's say maybe 5 years ago with M, you know, even moving. Like, I knew he was ill. I mean, I knew he was ill. I knew that wasn't even the best him coming through when he's actually putting out albums out there. So I decided to go back in. And that's actually when I started kind of just starting to take a look at these podcasts and all these reaction videos, because Cats were out there. I just stumbled upon it and had a couple of reaction videos, and they were reacting to M. And that just, I was like, hold on, M is doing this right now? And it was a different, it was when he shed Shady. You know, Shady was the Pop and Pills kid, and he was talking about like burying his wife and everything like that. And like that M after that, like when you sit there and decipher and you got Cats that were breaking down the bars, the double entendres, triple entendres, quadruple entendres, to where it would break your head trying to listen to this cat. And this is, and that's when I was like, hold on, take a huge step back and try to understand this old head now, prepared as hell to take on any of these new cats. And we haven't even heard his best right now, because he's always going to be saving it. He's probably going to be like 65, 70, putting out one track out there. It's like, this is what I was saving. And then boom, I'm hoping that that's the case. Cause
yeah, no,
I don't know.
It's,
I mean,
because I haven't heard him in a while. And
I know. I feel you, man.
I just like, okay, is he going to be top five?
We'll have to do some reaction videos.
All right, I'll accept that. E.
Don't get me wrong. M's filthy.
I'm sitting here.
There's no hero enough. So I'm like, he's not my favorite G.
Maybe we should ask Jeremy.
Jeremiah? Yeah, I don't know. Jeremy, like, I don't know if he dresses out of, I don't think this is an M look.
He looks like he listens to M though, but not the look.
Y'all, I haven't spelled submission too. Like, submission.
I was gonna ask you about that. I thought this was a whole slang thing. I was like, yeah, double man, M. Okay, whatever.
I mean, we got Jeremy.
Jeremy.
One love. Look at him.
Yeah. Hold on, what? Mad love, Jeremy.
Jay got to go bathroom in this picture.
I think he's
covering up.
Maybe his pants are falling.
Hiromi.
My guy. What's he holding? Oh, that's his phone. I thought that was a 40. All right. So, are you guys listening to rap right now? Like, man, any of the new heads
rap out there?
There's rap, bro.
There is. I'm actually not.
You know,
I'm not a good person.
It sucks just because it's, you know, we got these, you know, we got responsibilities.
Yeah,
you need to introduce it to us, Damon.
Okay. I'm pretty sure if you list like a couple of them songs, I'm like, oh yeah, But right now, everything out there is ratchet. You know, I'm loving the ratchet stuff.
A mumble, right? I mean, no, yeah. there's good cast out, and so we're probably gonna have to
bring into
that
mush.
So, have you guys heard of Coast Contra?
Mm-mm.
For weeks.
Well, you might have to play it right now.
Oh my goodness!
Definitely.
Here, let me. All right, so let's run this. I had to cut it for a second there because I wanted to make sure we bring this thing in because they've never heard of these cats. So it's Coast Contra. It's never freestyle. It's off the Breathe and Stop beat.
Mm-hmm.
The Breathe and there was one I heard of these guys a little bit before. Like, I think this was like maybe early last year or mid last year or something like that. But they did a freestyle also, but I had to listen to them again. Just peep it out, man. It's dope.
I'm a son of a gun with 16, bite the bullet. My style, Russian roulette, just be careful when you pull it. I had to pull some strings, I wish they was over acoustics. My flow stupid, doofus, I'm the blueprint. The twins is a pair, but I'm a two for one. This the moon and the sun, Frank Castle and Big Pun. Your punishment's begun. My split personality, split niggas for fun. The man in the mirror told me to pick a side. I got a different side, like a Gemini inside. Lives the bridge to the other side. Follow me down the rabbit hole where I had the golden heart. At the flippin' deep for the gang, I go to bat. Yo, where's Bruce Wayne? You strike me out as a lame in real life. The chains on the neck don't connect with the mainframe. The source, the fake going for, so refrain. When I pull up, pop out, say the name on them. Coast! Do my little thing, spit a flame on them. Coast! I can give a damn about the fame, nigga. I pull a card anywhere. I'm David Blaine on them. You think I'm the type? Nope, delete. Don't type nor retweet. I'm more elite than your PC. You and yours PC.
Yo, I'm gonna have to pause real quick. This isn't the Breathe and Stop.
That was
this
hard.
Isn't the Breathe and Stop, but this is hard. I think this is one of the first one that I had seen. Hold up, man. I really
hey, but they go hard though. That was hard.
This kid right here,
Yeah, I'm waiting for him.
Just wait. You never met the guy MC until now. It was all BC. I'm not gonna push a P. I'm not push a T. But I will push a T with your face on the double XL while my team's on the cover of the double XL magazine, little nigga. Disney's agreed with the album. Could put it into all of your grievances. All world peace, little nigga. Boy, this shit really slap on every volume like it was raised by smacking. It's like envy. One bring smoke to God house, but lack chimney. Coast got tatted, got 2 cents tatted. About the only things that under my skin can't offend me. I walk in truth, my fear branched off the noose. My eardrums request love from the roots. Make your whole family tree salute. Nothing new under the sun.
My eyes up on my dudes. Left, right, punch, kick, get the jump. No shit, oh shit, broke ribs. Still throwing both fists, don't miss. Now my medulla got contusions. I'm on my back, too many cats. I just see boomers. They started to run from boys in blue. Say I'm not a fan of the police, but hallelujah. Moral of the story, fellas, don't be stupid. Wanna meet a chick and take her ass to the movies. Back to the telly, but never give up your room key. Boys and girls, thank you for tuning in. Coast.
Whoo. Oh, that man.
Boy, that boy anchors.
How old is this?
That was your anchor, huh? This was last year's. This was his last year's. I really wanted
my, that gave me like a most deaf old school hip hop vibe.
Imagine just,
and that was filthy.
They were riding that shit. They were killing that shit.
Fire. That was fire.
He gave me like at first I thought he was giving me the ODB vibes with a little something else.
It
like
did come out extra, that way. Right? It did. Yep.
And he kind of has that face, but oh my goodness.
He came out. His delivery was tight. I enjoyed that. That was some musical stimulation.
Nah, so their newer stuff right now they actually excel when they vibe, they are back and forth on these, mm-hmm. these ciphers, and as they should.
That's
you know,
filthy.
I mean, sometimes the music and the beat itself keeps you in this kind of locked in on what you're gonna have to put out there, but at the same time, it's just when you get the opportunity to just go on one beat, just whatever you got prepped, and you could tell they've been together for a bit. You could tell they've been together for a bit. We're going to have to see some more, right? Uh-oh, he is frozen.
He's frozen.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Anyway, so we're at about that time. We're at about that time. I knew this episode was gonna allow that much of conversations around it. So I think it's time for us to kind of talk about next week's episode. And I don't think we have yet. I don't think we have yet. Is it time for us to bring in some conspiracies on what G wanted to do on day one, because you know
that was E.
Give him a teaser, G.
You said, did you hear about the day before 9/11? Have you heard some conspiracies around that?
That's because we were talking about calm down. 9/11. It was 9/11.
Next week, because you know it's election season. You know, just like it's election season. You remember the last time we had to vote on somebody, and all the world broke. So I think we're kind of heading towards that, and I think that can open up a can of worms. And you know, the thing about it with how it's all, like I was asking myself, why there's so many conspiracies now? It's like, why is it all out there? And it's because you know social media is out there.
Mm-hmm.
And now that Twitter changed over to X, they are allowing a lot more freedom to actually put more stuff out there that aren't being censored. So I think there's a lot more exposure to that. Are you guys on Twitter? A little bit?
No, not really.
A lot of Twitter. Yeah, it's a zoo.
I will though.
download or start. What is that? Thread? Is that IG?
Which one?
It's almost like a Twitter.
It's an
Instagram base. Yeah. So IG's Twitter.
It was a Facebook's alternate, and then I don't know. I think it was Zuck's alternate to Twitter. He was trying to go against them and all that stuff. But then
they still need to fight. So they need to duke it out. Still,
they need to do that thing.
Get their asses in the octagon.
All right. So we'll chop it up. We'll figure out what we would bring to the forefront. I mean, it's here. A lot of people are talking about conspiracies out there. I know there's a bunch of pods, and I don't want to be compared to those guys. So I want to talk about it and how it would affect our culture. I just don't want to put it out there. It's like, yeah, this is what's going on, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, this is what people are thinking, and this is so crazy. But then I want to talk about it thoughtfully and how it actually affects us.
Okay.
Not like white, you know, it's not a black or white issue. I just want to talk about more of like us as for as a Asian Pacific community, or maybe even just an Asian community. Because a lot, I think there's a lot of pods out there that bring it up. Hey, mm-hmm. This is what's going on. Isn't that crazy? And I was like, yeah, it's crazy, but let's take some deeper dives in this. So we'll be a lot more thoughtful. Take a lot of stuff into consideration. Maybe our tinfoil hats maybe won't be on, and just put it on the desk and we'll just talk about it as a whole. I think we should start next week. What y'all think?
Yeah. I'm with that.
Cool.
A lot of shit going on behind the scene.
Yeah, definitely.
A lot of stuff going behind the scene.
So for everybody else that's rocked with us up to this point, thank you so much. Please let us know in the comments, like and subscribe, you know, all that good stuff. Follow us on IG at Cloud. What is it?
Cloud.
Cold. Cold Rice Media. I'm sure we'll be hitting you guys up. So thank you so much. Last words, boys.
Peace. Oh,